Hi, I'm Elizabeth Safrit, Miss United States 2014, and I'm interviewing with thePageantGuy.com. Looking back on my crowning moment, I remember standing there with my first runner-up, Miss South Carolina, United States, Mayan Webb, and we were standing there holding hands, waiting for the winner to be announced, and the pageant was stopped. And the Miss World director, Stephen Douglas, and Miss World came out and announced that the winner would be going to Miss World. So I had that excitement on top of the pressure of whether or not I would win Miss United States. And I just remember being so nervous, and it seemed like the moment went on forever until they finally announced me as the winner. And I couldn't get down to the end of the runway fast enough. We had this huge, huge runway that I had to walk down all the way to be able to see my family and give them hugs. And I was down there for so long that they ended up having to call me back and say, Miss United States, can you please come back to the front so we can get pictures? Because I just wanted to give everybody a hug when I was down there, and I kept stopping to speak to people, and it didn't even connect with me that I needed to go back to the front. I just wanted to spend some time with my family and let them know how grateful I was for everything they've done to get me to that moment. So it was a really, really wonderful memory that I know I'll never be able to duplicate, but that I know is definitely the greatest moment of my life. Hi guys, now we are going to venture into my closet. Until I was 18, I had the smallest closet in the entire world, and finally my parents realized that everything was overflowing. Things were under my bed. Things were stuffed like everywhere they shouldn't be. So they turned the guest room into my closet, and it's amazing. I love it. So let's venture on inside. Welcome to my closet. This is pageant central right here. You can tell by all of the rhinestones and evening gowns, I'm sure. That's not just like casual wear. This is another pageant section. All the MacDougall stuff right here. Love that. Jacket section, because I'm always freezing, so I have hundreds and hundreds of jackets. Shoes, because they are a girl's best friend after all. And more shoes! Love it. So that's my closet. Hope you enjoyed. One thing that people don't know about me is that I love comic books. I have a huge collection from growing up. My brother and I would like go and actually trade comic books with other people, and we had a huge collection, and he actually got to go to Comic-Con, and he went without me, and I'm really, really jealous. He said it was amazing, so I'm hoping that's something that I can do one day. But we've got X-Men, we've got Superman, we've got Archie. That's actually our favorite, is Archie comics, and my favorite is Betty and Veronica of the Archie series. And I love that the main characters revolve around two women, which is not something that you see a lot from the 80s, 90s. And actually, this one right here is from 1991, before I was even born. And we have a few that are in their plastic wrap because they're just too important to even come out of that. This one is the 20th anniversary edition of X-Men. Very, very cool. And let me just give you a quick tour before we go here. These are all of our larger edition comics. And these are all Archie, Jughead, Betty, and Veronica. Very impressive, I know. So that's that fact about me. Now we have arrived at the most important part of the house, the fridge. Let's take a look inside. Like I said earlier, I try to eat really healthy, very clean. I gave up soda about a year and a half ago, so I always have some sort of sparkling water or sparkling soda in my fridge. Right now, I have pink grapefruit Perrier. It's delicious, and it's just as good as soda, in my opinion. I have olives. I love olives. I'm obsessed with olives. I always have these huge, huge olives in my fridge. Green olives, Kalamata olives. I love them all. So I always have that in my fridge. I always have fruit. Right now I have grapes, I have little clementines, I have raspberries, and I have huge, huge apples that are the size of softballs. And like I said, I just try to eat very healthy, very clean. It's the best way to get your body in shape for something like Miss World. It's just really good to live a clean, healthy lifestyle. So that's what I do. And the most important part of that is right over here. And it's Isagenics. This is how I'm getting my muscle and my body right from this world for the swimsuit portion of the competition. So right here, I have protein shakes, which I can take with me anywhere. I have Natural Accelerator, which is a nice vitamin for every day. I have an energy shot. I've got protein power bars. I've got cleanses. I have everything from them, and everything is amazing. I couldn't recommend it more. So that's a huge part of my daily diet, and now you have seen my diet throughout the day, and I hope you had fun. I want to give a very heartfelt thank you to everyone who helped me get to where I am today, to everyone who believed in me, to everyone who supported me and continues to support and believe in me on my journey to Miss World. Thank you so much. Thank you to my family and friends, to my coaches, my sponsors, my committee, my director. Thank you for all that you do for me and that you continue to do for me. I cannot express how grateful I am for all of you and for all that you do. I couldn't be here without you. I know that it really does take a village, and I'm so thankful that you guys are my village and that you guys are my pillars of support. So thank you very much. And I'm so excited to be representing the United States on the Miss World stage in London, England this December. Make sure you tune in to watch. It will be televised. Keep up with the Miss United States organization Facebook page, because we'll be posting more details closer to the pageant. Thank you all so much again, and I am so excited for Miss World.